burning of magnesium in air. It is important to understand the difference between physical and chemical changes. A physical change does not produce a new substance, and it can mean a change in size, shape, or the state of the matter of substance. A chemical change produces a new substance, and it can mean a change in color or odor, the appearance of bubbles, release of energy, or formation of a precipitate. Some examples of chemical changes are burning of wood, dissolving of salt in water, mixing acids and bases, and digesting food. Examples of physical changes are crumpling a sheet of paper, melting an ice cube, casting silver in a mold, and breaking a bottle. Our aim here is to carry out the reaction of burning magnesium in air and classifying it as a physical or chemical change. Materials required: magnesium ribbon, red litmus paper, a pair of tongs, and a Bunsen burner. Procedure: cut a piece of magnesium ribbon and hold it using a pair of tongs. Flame this ribbon in the Bunsen burner, collect the burnt ash in a watch glass, and label it as magnesium oxide. This is a chemical reaction, as oxygen and magnesium come together to form magnesium oxide. Now, take red litmus paper and moisten it with distilled water. Place the moist red litmus paper over the watch glass so that it is in contact with the magnesium oxide. You can now see that the red litmus turns blue. From this, we can infer that magnesium oxide is basic in nature. This reaction shows a chemical change as the reactants, oxygen and magnesium, combine together to form a new substance, that is, magnesium oxide. The formed magnesium oxide has different chemical composition, which is different from both magnesium and oxygen. Precautions: make sure you hold the magnesium ribbon securely with a pair of tongs while burning it. It is better to use sunglasses to protect the eyes from the bright white light produced by burning magnesium, because it contains ultraviolet light that can permanently damage the retina of the eyes.